and welcome back to Inversion Addicts. Today we're going to be taking a look at my top 10 lost rides of Alton Towers. So this can include a ride or attraction that no longer features at the park. So let's get into it. So kicking things off and in at number 10, it's Energizer, later renamed Bone Shaker. Energizer originally opened in Festival Park in 1995 and stood thrilling guests up until around 1998 when it was relocated to X Sector as part of the new themed land. Although this relocation would only last around 3 seasons and in 2001 was relocated back to Uggland, which was the re-theme of Festival Park. Upon its return to Uggland, it would also be re-themed itself to fit in with its surroundings and would now be called the Bone Shaker. The updated theming to fit in with Uggland was absolutely superb, and for me, Bone Shaker stood as a fantastic flat ride that was suitable for all ages. Unfortunately, as the years ticked on, the Bone Shaker would become unreliable and far too costly for the park to maintain. It would be standing but not operating at the start of the 2004 season before being removed to make way for Rita Queen of Speed, which of course debuted in the 2005 season. The ride, manufactured by Mondial, played its part as a stepping stone in the growth of Alton Towers, but I'm sure I'm not the only one who has some fond memories of the Bone Shaker. So up next, and in at number 9, we've got Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, the ride. Opening to the public in 2006, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory was an indoor dark water ride, and was said to have cost over £8 million to design and create. The all-round experience and theming for the ride was absolutely outstanding, and I still remember entering my boat and taking a journey down the Chocolate River. You would of course go on a journey through the Chocolate Factory and meet some familiar faces such as the Oompa Loompa and my favourite, Augustus Gloop. The ride stood as a replacement for Around the World in 80 Days and stood amusing riders for almost a decade. It was eventually removed from the park in 2015 to make way for future developments. So coming in at number 8, to divide some opinions, it's Submission. Opening to the public in 2001, Submission was located inside X Sector. It was an intense flat ride, stood menacingly next to Oblivion and Enterprise, and the theming really suited the area. The ride, created by Chance Morgan, was a double inverter and stood thrilling guests for almost 13 years, but of course wasn't without its problems. The ride developed a reputation for being a rougher experience, and for the years running up to the Smilers opening in 2013, was only operating one side. The limited throughput and negative reception to the ride seemed to seal Submission's fate, and the ride was removed for the start of the 2014 season. So coming in hot at number 7, it's the Alton Beast. The Alton Beast started its life in 1988 in an area of the park located behind Talbot Street. It would stand thrilling guests for around 4 years until it was relocated to Thunder Valley. The ride was repainted bright red and named the New Beast in 1992, where it stood proudly in Thunder Valley up until the end of the 1997 season. It was then removed to make way for the development of Ur, which I'm sure you'll all agree was much, much better. But that doesn't take away the legacy left by this classic Schwarzkopf coaster. So, dropping in at number 6, it's Nemesis Subterra, which opened to the public in 2012. Nemesis Subterra was marketed as your worst nightmare underground. The ride consisted of 4 ABC ride freefall drop towers, but to be fair, had an underwhelming drop of only 6 metres or 20 feet. During the ride, you'd hit a speed of around 21 miles per hour and experience G's of around 3.5. The ride, of course, was themed around Nemesis and the discovery of a nest of eggs located in a network of underground tunnels. Now, although Nemesis Subterra lacked as a drop tower, it made up for it in its overall experience and theming. The ride unfortunately closed on the 7th of August 2015 and still remains standing but not operating to this day. Although, on my visit during the 2021 season, I noticed a cleanup of the ride area and also a cue board out front with some mysterious question marks. So maybe keep your eyes peeled for a future in history video? Who knows? So here we are, we've made it to the halfway point in the video. And coming in hot at number 5, it's Thunder Looper. Thunder Looper opened to the public in the year 1990 and was a shuttle coaster created by Schwarzkopf. During the ride, you'd hit a top speed of 53 miles per hour and was a high octane, thrilling roller coaster located in Thunder Valley, which would of course later become Forbidden Valley. Unfortunately, Thunderlooper's life was short-lived and was removed in the 1996 season. This was mainly due to the fact Thunderlooper didn't conform to Alton Towers' tree-line policy and was a noisy roller coaster, which resulted in complaints from nearby residents. Forbidden Valley opened in the 1997 season without Thunderlooper, and the rest is history. So up next, we're travelling back over to X Sector and we're going to be taking a look at number 4, which is the Black Hole. Opening to the public in 1984, the Black Hole was a Schwarzkopf Jetstar 2 model and was located entirely inside a tent in what would become X Sector. Black Hole was a staple part of the offering in the early days Alton Towers, and I still remember having a fantastic ride in the dark. The tent originally was bright yellow and green, before it was rethemed to match the Oblivion and X Sector theming, and unfortunately took its last guests in early 2005, before remaining standing but not operating up until around February 2007. At this point, the roller coaster was removed, but the tent remained standing for a number of years after, and was used for some skirmazes up until around 2012, when it was of course demolished to make way for Secret Weapon 7. So here we are, we've made it to the top 3 lost rides of Alton Towers, and coming in hot at number 3, it's the Log Flume. Opening to the public in 1981, this legendary log flume was the longest of its kind in the world upon opening. The theming really did what it said on the tin, and the ride was themed around a simple log transportation system. The incredible layout would take you out and back through the woods, and not only did it hold the world record for the longest flume, but was regarded as one of the finest flumes in the UK. By 2004, the flume was ready for an upgrade, and it was in the 2004 season that the log flume was officially rethemed to the flume and was sponsored by Imperial Leather. This is where we ended up with the most terrifying rubber duck of all time, and to be fair, the retheme with the bathtub-shaped flumes was received well by the public. The flume would continue to stand soaking guests up until just prior to the 2015 Skirfest event. This is when it was announced by Alton Towers that the flume would remain closed for the rest of the season, but unfortunately, the 10th of October 2015 marked the last operating day of the flume. It was removed shortly after to make way for Secret Weapon 8. So here we go, top 2, and coming in at number 2, it's Ripsaw. Ripsaw opened to the public in 1997 and was a Huss topspin located in Forbidden Valley. The ride featured extensive theming and an amazing water package, and sat fantastically alongside Nemesis and Galactica, or Ur as it was known for the majority of Ripsaw's life. The ride stood as an official replacement as one of our previous entries, Thunderlooper, and was a welcomed addition to the park upon its opening. In my opinion, it added a fantastic offering down at Forbidden Valley, and as well as being one of the most photographed rides in the park, the water splash element added a new dimension to the ride that I feel the park misses out on in its modern day offering. I think it's safe to say that one area that Alton Towers lacks in is flat rides, which is why Ripsaw earns its spot so high on the list. So, we've finally made it. It's down to our number 1 lost ride of Alton Towers. And taking the top spot, it's the absolute old wives' tale of a coaster, Corkscrew. Corkscrew originally opened to the public in 1980, and it was Alton Towers' first investment in a major coaster. The coaster was designed and manufactured by Vekoma and stood at a height of 75 feet. That's 23 metres. You'd hit a top speed of around 40 miles per hour, and you'd famously traverse through the double corkscrew that you can still see featured at the entrance to the park to this day. Although throughout its life, the corkscrew had a couple of theme changes and a new paint job. After over 25 years in operation, the corkscrew took its last riders on the 9th of November 2008. Now, although there was nothing necessarily special about the ride, I'm sure you'll all agree it holds a special place in the heart of any Alton Towers fan. It was fantastic to see the park paying homage to this classic by immortalising the double corkscrew outside the entrance, and for me it stands as a constant reminder of the foundations this amazing coaster laid for the future of this incredible park. That being said, I'd love to hear your thoughts on the matter. Do you have fond memories of any of the rides featured on my list? And what rides do you feel should have got a mention? Be sure to let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you're enjoying the content. My name's Lee from Inversion Addicts, and until next time, take care.